We can make a decent amount of profit from Dragon Response missions once we understand how the reward system works. In this video, we will explain everything in details and see exactly how to make as much gold as possible from the Dragon Response missions. Before we get started, if you want to see short and simple guides on all kinds of Guild Wars 2 content and know all the details about any updates and changes that happen to the game, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to stay up to date with the new guides whenever they are posted. The first source of gold will be the loot you get from killing mobs inside any of the missions. Sometimes this will be very good and very valuable, and you will get some lodestones and tier 6 materials, for example. The second source is from the end chest that you get every time you finish any mission, and they have no daily limit. If you do 100 missions per day, you will get that end chest 100 times. The chest will contain some random loot like unidentified gear, marks, and crests. And if you activate one or more challenges during the missions, you will get even more loot from the end chest. However, there are two more important items we can get from the chests that will enable us to make some extra gold. The first one are the prismatic crystals. Those are not a guaranteed drop, but you will have a decent chance of getting them from the end chest. You can then use those crystals to craft prismatic ingots, which at the time of this video you can sell on the trading post for a very decent amount. But always pay attention to the price, because if it dropped too much, then it may not be profitable to make those ingots and sell them anymore, and you may actually make a loss. So always calculate the cost of the materials first compared to the profit you will make from selling those ingots, and don't forget to take the taxes away. Those ingots are needed to craft those Dragon Slayer weapons, and you can get the recipes from this vendor with the Tyrian defense seals. There will be more recipes for more Dragon Slayer weapons and better looking ones in the future that you will also be able to buy recipes for, and most likely they will also need those prismatic ingots. So there is a big chance that those ingots will always be valuable and profitable to craft. The second reward we get from the end chest are those Tyrian defense seals, and they are a guaranteed drop that you will get every single time you do any of the missions. If you finished a mission that does not have any challenges enabled, you will get about 4 to 6 seals from the end chest. And if you enabled all the challenges, you will get about 15 seals when you are done. We can use those seals to buy many items, as you can see, which include some skins, and they include some unique recipes, and we can also buy something called supply box. We can right click and preview what items can we possibly get from those supply boxes. This way you know exactly what to expect. And the numbers you see on those items are the minimum that you will get from them. You will notice there are two tabs. The first one is for the items you get from the Ebon Vanguard faction, and the second one will be from the Crystal Bloom. Those were the two factions that we helped before this chapter. So you will only be able to find the items here from the factions we have helped in the past, but not the faction we are currently helping. For example, right now we are helping the dwarves, and whenever we are done with them and we move on to the next faction, then you will most likely find the dwarf rewards back here at the Defense Tyrian Seal Merchant, and you will find a third tab for them. The main item we want from this merchant to make as much gold as possible will be those supply boxes. But of course, you can also buy the skins and the recipes if you are interested in them. As of the time I'm recording this video, the Ebon Vanguard supply boxes are more profitable than the Crystal Bloom ones. However, of course, that may change in the future as the prices change. You will also see another vendor that is Seal Discount Vendor. You will only be able to talk to them when you finish the third Mastery Great Champion in the Ice Broad Saga in Dragon Slayer. This merchant will sell only limited items per day, and you can only buy those items once per day. Every day those items will be different, and you will buy them using those Tyrian defense seals. And once you buy this item, it disappears and you cannot buy it anymore. So you can only buy one of whatever items this merchant is selling per day. So make sure to check it all the time because it can have some valuable items. And as you noticed, the one item we bought was those Deldramore supply boxes, which was not available in this normal defense seal vendor, because we are still currently helping the dwarf faction as you saw. The third source of rewards will be the daily chest you get from each mission when you finish it for the first time. You will get that chest only once per day, per mission. It doesn't matter if you did this mission with challenges enabled or not. So for example, if I did the Metrica province mission for the first time today, I will get that daily chest. But if I did the same Metrica province mission in the same day, I will not get that daily chest again. This chest will contain 10 seals plus some karma and some mastery experience. And we already explained how can we make some profit from those seals. Next, we have this vendor called Support Mark Vendor, which will sell some items using those support marks based on whatever faction we are currently helping. The first tab will contain items you can buy using those marks, and one of them will always be supply boxes for those factions we are currently helping. So right now we are helping dwarves, and so the supply boxes are Deldramore supply box. And as of the time of this video, those Deldramore supply boxes are the most profitable ones. They are more profitable than the Ebon Vanguard and Crystal Bloom we can buy from this vendor. But again, of course, the prices can change in the future. The second tab will offer those support marks in exchange of some materials. And those materials change every day. So make sure to check this vendor and the second tab every day. You can only buy a maximum of 5 marks per day, and so the best thing to do is to calculate how much it will cost from each of those items and buy 5 marks using the cheapest option. And last, we have a set of dailies that you can do for even more rewards, and you can find them in the Daily Champions under the Daily tab. 3 of those dailies, those 3 right here, will give you those chests called Chest of the Dragon Slayer, which will contain 5 defense seals. They will contain some karma and some mastery XP. The fourth one, which is the Daily Dragon Responder, the first reward when you do the first mission will be 3 prismatic crystals. When you do a second mission, you will get 2 more crystals. And when you do a third mission, you will get 1 more. So in total, you can get a guaranteed of 5 prismatic crystals from this Daily Dragon Responder. Keep in mind that those are the guaranteed ones, but you still have a chance to get extra crystals when you do the missions from the end chest. This Daily Dragon Responder will need you to finish any 3 missions. They do not have to be the 2 missions you will find here in the dailies. There is also another set of dailies that you can find under the bonus events. However, they only work during the first week of us helping any new faction. You will know that when you see those dailies functioning, but also there will be this big orange event that will be running globally for everyone in the game, and this will be available during the first week of any time we are helping a new faction. You will find a countdown timer of when this event will be over, and as long as it's running, you will have those extra set of dailies. Those extra bonus dailies will give you a lot of marks that you can then use to buy those unique items or the supply boxes to make some extra profit. So in conclusion, the best thing to do with those dailies is to do those 2 daily missions, and of course they will change every day, and then do whatever third mission you want. And if you can activate the challenges on any of them or all of them, then of course you are going to make more profit. And when we have those daily bonus events that we have available, then try to do them every day, and remember they will only be available during the first week of us helping any new faction. This Saturday at 5 PM GMT, I will be doing a Twitch live stream that will explain how can you get started with fractals, even if you are completely new to the game or completely new to fractals. And we will also explain the mechanics for a few of them. And fractals are definitely one of the best content you can do in Guild Wars 2, not just for the gold, so make sure to stop by with us on Saturday to watch the stream live, and I will leave the link to my channel in the comments and description, and if you go to the channel, you will also see a countdown that shows you exactly when the stream is going to start, this way we can avoid any confusion. And I will also leave my Twitter and Discord links below, so that you can stay up to date with everything we will do and get notified before we go live or post any new videos or simply to get in direct contact with me. We will make another giveaway exactly like the last one, and we will have one winner that will get one bag slot expansion and a 20 slot bag to go with it. I did not plan to make another giveaway so soon, but from your very positive comments on the last giveaway and how much you thought it was useful to have those backslot expansion, I decided to make another giveaway for it, especially since they are on sale. But please understand that this does not mean that every single video from now on is going to have giveaways. I will try to make them more often and more frequently, but not with every single video. To participate in the giveaway, all I need is your username that have numbers beside it, and then whoever is going to win will receive a mail with the prizes in it. But please make sure you don't add any quotes. If you do add quotes in your comment, you will be disqualified. However, of course, you can include anything else if you want. You can ask a question, you can leave feedback, you can suggest, or you can simply leave a comment with your username only and that will do. This giveaway will be over tomorrow, Friday, on Daily Reset, which is the 29th of January. And I will make sure to edit the description and the comment and the title to indicate that the giveaway is over. If you want to see more short and simple guides on all kinds of Guild Wars 2 content, and know all the details about any updates and changes that will happen to the game, then don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay up to date with the new guides whenever they are posted. Thank you very much for watching.